Hello everyone, welcome to CSS World. In this video, we will cover the idea of Lebensraum, which was one of the top reasons behind the World War II. So here we go. First of all, introduction of Lebensraum. Lebensraum is basically the territory which a group, state or nation believes is needed for its natural development. It is a German concept which actually means living space. The German concept of Lebensraum comprises policies and practices of settled colonialism which proliferated in Germany from the 1890s to 1940s. Lebensraum became a geopolitical goal of Imperial Germany in World War I between 1914 to 1918. The most extreme form of this ideology was supported by the Nazi Party and Nazi Germany until the end of World War II. Now the background of Lebensraum. The term Lebensraum was coined by the German geographer Friedrich Ratzel. During the last two decades of the 19th century, Ratzel developed a theory according to which the development of all species, including humans, is primarily determined by their adaptation to geographic circumstances. Above all, Ratzel considered species migration as the crucial factor in social adaptation and cultural change. He was of the view that species that successfully adapted to one location would spread naturally to others. Indeed, he went on to argue that in order to remain healthy, species must continuously expand the amount of space they occupy. He considered migration as a natural feature of all species. This process also applied to humans, who operate collectively in the form of people, with one effectively conquering another. However, according to Ratzel, such expansion could be successful only if the conquering nation colonized the new territory. Idea of Lebensraum in Germany. Between 1921 and 1925, Adolf Hitler developed the belief that Germany required Lebensraum, that is, living space, in order to survive. The conviction that this living space could be gained only in the East and specifically from Russia formed the core of this idea and shaped his policy after his takeover of power in Germany in 1933. So where did he get this idea from, and why did he envisaged his country's future living space lying in the East? To know these things, let us have a look on pre-war intellectual fashion. Ratzel's ideas very much accorded with intellectual fashions in late 19th and early 20th century, where various forms of social Darwinism were prevalent, and where there was a growing concern about the allegedly negative effects of industrialization and urbanization. There was also a belief in the virtues of agrarian society and specifically of the peasantry. Ratzel's ideas also fitted into the general debate about German imperialism. The idea of increasing Germany's strength by encouraging migration to Germany's colonies had developed during the 1880s and 1890s. It was thought that sending settlers to the colonies could be an attractive alternative to simply trading in their raw materials. Whereas economic imperialism was particularly popular with industry, migrationist colonialism became associated with agrarianism. Moreover, during the years immediately preceding World War I, the focus of this colonialism shifted from the settlement of overseas colonies to the idea of conquering territory in Eastern Europe and of settling it with German peasants. The leading advocate of this notion was the influential Chauvinist pressure group, the Pan-German League, and its associated propagandists. Of these, perhaps the most notable was the retired general and radical conservative publicist Friedrich von Bernhardi. In his notorious book, Germany and the Next War, he used many of Ratzel's ideas to advocate using a victorious war to gain space in Eastern Europe for the settlement of peasants farmers. Now the impetus of Lebensraum during World War I. The notion of acquiring Lebensraum in Eastern Europe thus became quite a familiar one before the war, and it gained even more impetus as Germany went through the experience of World War I. The crucial turning point in the development of the Lebensraum program occurred when German armies conquered Poland and Western Russia after 1914. A German military regime was established in the Baltic provinces and in part of White Russia under the command of General Erich. The situation became formalized with the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk signed by the new Soviet regime in March 1918. Even after the end of war, German irregular troops, the so-called Free Corps, continued to operate in the Baltic states in a guerrilla war against the Bolsheviks, fought with exceptional brutality on both sides. The post-war German government, hoping to dominate the new Baltic republics, encouraged this process and promised land to the troops. Eventually, however, at the end of 1919, the Allies forced their disbandment and the Free Corps returned to Germany. Embittered and frustrated, some of their members found a home in Hitler's Nazi Party. Influence of Lebensraum on Hitler. Hitler had already started his political career in 1919 and had been influenced by this kind of pan-German thinking, but he was not yet clear about where the expansion should take place, nor about what alliance he would need in order to achieve it. To begin with, he was not hostile towards Russia and saw Britain and France as Germany's main enemies. Indeed, during 1919, he blamed Germany's pre-war politicians for supporting Austria-Hungary against Russia. But by 1920, he was arguing that an alliance between Russia and Germany can come about only when Jewry is removed. And by 1924, when he came to write Mein Kampf, he had concluded that Russia would be the target for Germany's drive to acquire Lebensraum. So, how did this change of approach come about? Hitler's views on Russia during these early years were strongly influenced by Alfred Rosenberg, who had joined the Nazi Party in 1920 and became the editor of its newspaper. Rosenberg was a Baltic German who was studying in Moscow when the Russian Revolution broke out in 1917 and left Russia for Germany in November 1918. Thus, he had experienced the Bolshevik Revolution at first hand and became convinced that it was the work of the Jews. Hitler considered Rosenberg as an expert on Russia and became equally persuaded of the link between Bolsheviks and Jews. By 1922, it was becoming apparent that the Bolshevik regime in Russia was there to stay. Indeed, it was clear from an interview Hitler gave in December 1922 that by then he had decided that an alliance with a Bolshevik Russia was out of the question. Germany would be better off working with Britain and Italy, which appeared to be resisting French hegemony in Europe against Russia, which could in turn provide Germany's necessary Lebensraum. Hitler's views on Russia had been further hardened by his contacts with Baltic German exiles in Munich. Mein Kampf. The final elaboration of Hitler's program for acquiring Lebensraum occurred while he wrote his renowned book Mein Kampf during 1924-1925. Essentially, this involved his study of geopolitics, that is, the impact of the environment on politics, which provided him with a quasi-scientific justification for the plans he had already worked out. During his period in Landsberg prison, where he had been following the failure of his notorious Munich Beer Hall coup in November 1923, he read and discussed Ressel's work and other geopolitical literature provided by a Munich professor of geography called Haschhofer and fellow prisoner Rudolf Hess. Haschhofer emphasized the extremely unfavorable situation of the Reach from the viewpoint of military geography and Germany's limited resources of food and raw materials, and no doubt thus provided Hitler with an intellectual justification for his views. These were expressed in Mein Kampf and remained fundamentally the same through the following years. Indeed, an important reason for his decision to invade the Soviet Union in June 1941 was his desire to acquire the Lebensraum that he had been seeking for Germany since 1925. He envisaged settling Germans as a master race in Western Russia while deporting most of the Russians to Siberia and using the remainder as slave labor. In this way, the Lebensraum became one of the reasons of World War II. World War II has been covered in another lecture, the link of which is available in the description. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye.